This video will demonstrate how to add a component to the piping library. This part is a ball valve, modeled in SOLIDWORKS. It has two configurations, a 3/4 inch size and a 1/2 inch size, and the configurations are managed with a design table. A wizard is available to help convert a SOLIDWORKS part into a routing component. We access it from the Library Manager. It's called the Routing Component Wizard. We select the application and the type of component from this list. As the legend points out, red indicates the item is required. A preview window shows what the item looks like. This particular type of component requires two connection points. A connection point is where the pipe is attached to the component. The yellow message explains what can be selected. I'll pick a face and make sure the direction is going the right way. We select the pipe that we want to use, as well as the configuration. We need another connection point for this type of part. Again, we select the location, the direction, the pipe, and the configuration. We need a route point. This is where the component will attach to the sketch. This screen's satisfied, so we'll go to the next one. This type of part requires a vertical axis. We don't have one modeled, so we'll create one now. And I'll create it using the intersection of two planes. At this point, the part modeling is complete. If a design table already exists, the wizard checks it out. And if it doesn't exist, it's here we would create one. If anything is missing in the table that it needs, it lets us know. There's one column we need to add. The column has been added, but it's not filled in, so we need to do that now. This column is a property for the diameter. We also need to make sure all the connection point diameters are correct. This screen is for entering custom property information. It can be done now or later through File Properties. We give this component a name and a location, and then save it. We're back at the beginning, and we don't want to add any more components, so we'll stop this command. Now let's test it. I'll edit this route. Find the component that we just added to the library. Drag it in, rotate it if necessary. There's the two configurations that we created. And it looks good. In summary, we can add parts to the piping library using the routing component wizard.